Welcome to the Calcutta Races season 2020-2021 summer meeting, fourth day, Wednesday, 31st March 2021 race preview. Race number one, the Aristocrat Handicap for horses rated 1 to 26, about 1100 meters.
The first runner we are looking at is Anika. Anika has had three starts. It started out with a win in race number 23, where it went over 1200 meters and beat Estrella Star. Since then, Anika has raced over 1100 meters in his next two starts. In its last start, Anika was travelling in third spot. And when the race came to a boil, Anika faded very badly, finished on 6th of 8 runners. The winner here was Krisha's Choice. Next up, we are looking at two runners here. Number 3, Berluti, who generally goes on a start-to-finish mission in all its starts. The best start it had was in race number 78, where it finished on 3rd behind Windchaser. In his last start, Berluti again was racing in front, and when challenged for the lead, settled for 3rd spot. We also have number 8, which is Ayana. Ayana was racing in 2nd spot, but when the race came to a boil, and Ayana gave up and finished on 8th of 8 runners, about 8 lengths from the winner. Next up, we have two runners we are looking at. Number 4, Zodiac Prince, and number 7, Buddy Holly. Zodiac Prince has had four starts in this season. Its best start was its last start in race number 99, where it went on a start-to-finish mission in the white and red jacket towards the inside. Was leading the pack till about last 25 meters, where it fell short by a nose to Bemuse. And we had Buddy Holly. Buddy Holly had won a race in race number 86, where it beat Beowulf. And its next start, Buddy Holly came up with a late dash and finished third behind Bemuse. Next up, we're looking at number 6, Demonstrate. After being off board in its first four start in this season, very strongly fancied in race number 87, yet it only managed to finish 5th behind Spring Valley. In its last start in race number 100, where Demonstrate was racing in 7th spot, made 1 place and finished on 6th of 9 runners behind Ember Glow.
Race number 2, the Zelda Handicap, for horses rated 41 to 66, about 1200 meters.
The first runner we are looking at is number 1, Treasure Hunt. Treasure Hunt was a winner in his last two start. In his first race it won is race number 60 over 1200 meters, where it was racing in 4th spot, then came up with a late charge and won that race, beating Mystic Star. In his last start, Treasure Hunt was ridden in a similar fashion into the last 200 meters, burst through the pack and won that race, going away about 3.5 lengths in front of Viraggio. Next up, we are looking at number 2, Apna Time Aayega. Apna Time Aayega won in a race in race number 107 over 1400 meters. In his last start, Apna Time Aayega was very tardy to begin, but made up the ground in the first 400 meters, then raced in second last spot as they entered the home straight, made late gains and finished on 3rd, about 5 lengths from the winner, which was Cliffhanger. Next, we have three runners we are looking at. Number 3, Astral Force. Astral Force has raced in Bangalore and had a run here in race number 107, where it was racing in 8th spot and stayed on in 8th. And we have number 5, which is Estrella Star, winner in two starts in race number 61 and race number 74, where it beat Adornica and Nova. In its next start, it finished on 5th. And we have number 6, which is Daring Heart. Daring Heart was a winner in race number 42. Since then, has placed 3rd in its post start, in his last start, behind Apna Time Aayega, about 3 lengths from the winner. Next, we are looking at two runners here. Number 4, Harbour Sunrise. Harbour Sunrise came down from southern India, had a run in race number 104, where it finished on 9th of 10 runners. And we have number 7, Lumos. Lumos has had 4 starts in this season without placing in any of them. In his last start, Lumos was travelling in 7th spot and stayed on in 7th behind Code Jester. Next, we look at number 8, Freeze. Freeze came down from Bombay, has had 3 starts since. In first, it had a run in race number 11, where it finished on 5th after leading the pack. And in its last start, Freeze was travelling in 2nd spot, then weakened to finish on 5th. And it was reported that Freeze had blood to the nostrils, and the winner here was Valorous Thal.
Race number 3, the Own Opinion Handicap for horses rated 1 to 26, about 1400.
The first runner we are looking at is number 1, Balerion, the son of Planetair. And in its only start, Balerion was very slow to begin, raced in 6th spot of 6 as they turned for Rome. Did not make any impression, race detached from the field. The winner was Bemuse, who won that race in a close finish by a nose. Next up, you're looking at number 2, Triple Distilled. Has had couple of starts so far, the son of Corporate Jungle. In his last start, was racing in prominently in 2nd spot as they entered the home straight. And then weakened to finished 8th of 9 runners. The winner here was Spring Valley. Ashwamegh is the next runner we're looking at, and Ashwamegh has been quite consistent in the 7 start it has had. It has placed 3 of them. In his last start, Ashwamegh was travelling wide throughout and came even wider on the extreme outside and made late gains to save place money behind Despacito, who was a runaway winner. Despacito won that race by about 8 lengths, and Ashwamegh settled for 3rd. Next, we have 2 runners. We are looking at number 4, Tomorrow Forever. Tomorrow Forever has had 7 starts in this season. It earlier placed in race number 22, where it finished on 2nd. We also have number 7, Tahoe. Tahoe was racing in 4th spot as they took the turn, and then Tahoe came up with a run on the down the center and finished on 3rd behind Ember Glow, where Tomorrow Forever finished on 5th. Next, we're looking at number 5, Stagger. Stagger has had a couple of starts. In his last start, Stagger was racing in last spot, made up one place and finished on 7th. And it was reported that Stagger was trotting lame after the race. And the winner here in race number 86 was Buddy Holly, who won that race in a 3-way finish by a neck. Next up, we're looking at number 6, Jinsuku. The son of Speaking of Which, 3 starts. It was fancied in an earlier start in race number 64, where it went out as the favorite but finished on 4th behind Yahalla, who has won again since. And its last start, Jinsuku was traveling in 2nd spot. However, when the race came to a Boyle Huntsman, who kicked away from that field and won that by 4.5 lengths, Jinsuku had to settle for 4th spot, almost 9 lengths from the winner.
Next, we're looking at race number 4, the Captain Courageous Handicap for horses rated 21 to 46, 1600 meters.
We have 4 runners. We're looking at first, number 1, Scarlet Witch. Scarlet Witch won back-to-back starts in race number 59 and race number 98. Since then, it finished on 10th in its last start, where it met with some interference. And then we have number 2, Intellection. Intellection, after winning a race in race number 30 over 2000 meters, in its last start, Intellection was traveling in 5th spot. Came up with a run down the center and won that race by about half a length. And we also had number 3, Headboy. Headboy has placed 3rd in this race after racing in 4th spot prominently. Sea Sky, another runner who has been on board since its debut in this season, has been in its last start. Sea Sky had a erratic run where it finished on 8th of 12 runners, almost 9 lengths from the winner. Next up, we're looking at number 5, Indicator, the son of Crimson China. Indicator has been consistent in his last 3 starts, has saved place money. In his last start, despite being slow out, Indicator made up the ground, and in the last 300 meters, Indicator was the one who was moving fastest of all, but the race was already over. Huntsman won that by 4.25 lengths, and the Indicator had to settle for 2nd spot. We move on to the 5th race of the afternoon, the Obolensky Handicap for horses rated 61 to 86 to be run over a distance of 1600 meters.
First, we're looking at horse number 2, Inca, last raced in race number 97 over a distance of 2000 meters. Inca has had 5 starts this season, had placed 2nd in its last start. The winner of that race was Apsara Star. Inca will be ridden by Suraj Naredu this time. Next, we're looking at horse number 3, Dancing Lord, last raced in race number 82 over a distance of 1600 meters. Dancing Lord has had 3 starts this season, all over the same distance. Came second in its last start to Tudor Hall, was ridden by Dashrath Singh. Now will be ridden by apprentice jockey Sujit Kumar Paswan. Next, we're looking at horse number 4, Top Notch. Top class out of Elzam, the 5-year-old bay gelding has changed stables from Manvindra Singh and has last raced last year on the 2nd of Feb. The long 1-year layoff. Let's see how Top Notch performs. Next, we're looking at horse number 5, Ghost. Last raced in race number 88 over a distance of 2,000 meters. Ghost has had 5 starts this season, has had 2 seconds, 2 wins and placed a third in all 5 starts. His last run, he placed second to Cliffhanger, will be ridden by Hindu Singh. Race number 6, the Calcutta Million 2020-2021 Grade 3 for horses 3 years old only, 1600 meters.
The first runner we are looking at is number 1, Cletus. Cletus is by David Livingston out of Fly Like the Wind, who was a classic winner. And Cletus in his first start went on a start to finish mission, was racing handy as they entered the home straight. There was not much the jockey had to do on him. Cletus absolutely drew away from that field on tight reins and won that race going away by about 5 1/4 lengths, beating Lady Laurent. Next up, we're looking at 2 runners here, Gallen and number 3, Jake. Gallen placed second in each of his 2 starts, both times behind Jake. And Jake is a winner of its 2 starts, Win Legend out of Verona. In its first start, Jake won that race by about 1 1/4 lengths, over 1200 meters. In his next start, Jake was racing in third spot. Then when asked for an effort, came to challenge Gallen and won that race in a close finish by a neck. And Gallen had to finish for second spot. Next up, we are looking at number 4, Centurion. And Centurion, after finishing 5th in his first start over 1200 meters behind Cletus, in his next start, Centurion was racing in 2nd spot and when asked for an effort, drew away from that field, won that race by 9 1/4 lengths and absolutely pulverized the opposition that day. The best UV could finish was almost a distance behind, and UV has since won a race. Lastly, we're looking at number 5, Lady Laurent. Lady Laurent has had 3 starts, placed 2nd first time in behind Cletus, then finished on 5th behind Delfini. In its last start, Lady Laurent was making the pace, however, when asked for an effort into the last 300 meters, dropped back, finished on 4th of 5 runners, almost 7 1/2 lengths behind the winner, which was Delfini.
Race number 7, the Brave Dancer Cup, for horses rated 81 and above 1400 meters.
The first runners we are looking at is number 1, New England. New England has had quite a few starts. Its best start was in the beginning of the season in race number 20, where it finished on 2nd behind Psychic Force. We have number 2, Into the Spotlight, who has come down from Bangalore, has had a couple of starts. In the last start, it was racing in 6th spot, then made 1 place and finished on 5th. We also have number 3, which is a Rekha Legend, who also came down from Southern India, has had 3 starts, was racing prominently last time out, finished on 6th of 9 runners. We also have number 5, which is Sagittarius. Sagittarius generally likes to go over longer distance. In his last start over 1100 meters, Sagittarius finished on 9th of 9 runners. We also have number 6, Capricious. Capricious was racing in 3rd spot and weakened slightly to finish on 4th. The winner of this race was Abhay Gama, who won that race by about 1 1/2 lengths. Next up, we're looking at number 4, Rainbow Trout, and daughter of Lita Moore. Since it came down from Western India, has won both of its starts. First beat Izzy by about 5 lengths. Next took on the mighty Jayavant and beat that by 5 1/4 lengths. And Rainbow Trout now will be ridden by Suraj Naredu. We're looking at number 7, Shimmering Star, is a son of Strong Suit. Shimmering Star has reeled off back-to-back 3 winners so far. First, it beat Dash over 1100 meters. In its next start, it beat Valorous Thal by about neck. In its last start, Shimmering Star was taking on Dandy March, who had an outing in Western India. And Shimmering Star won that race by 2 3/4 lengths. Next up, we're looking at number 8, Tudor Hall. a daughter of Kindaka, since coming down from Western India, has had 1-2 starts so far. First, it beat Kimaya by about 3.5 lengths. Next, it beat Dancing Lord by 4.5 lengths. And today, Tudor Hall is going to be ridden by C.S. Jodha.
Race number 8, the Allodium Handicap, for horses rated 41 to 66, about 1400 meters.
The first two runners we're looking at is number 1, Oakbrook. Oakbrook was racing in 5th spot in race number 108, where it eventually finished on 4th. And we also had number 2, Kimaya. Kimaya has been knocking on the doors since the beginning of the season, where it has finished 2nd twice in its next 2 starts. Kimaya has finished on 3rd in each of his starts. In the last start, it took on the mighty Silver Bracelet and came short by almost 2 lengths. Next, we're looking at two runners here. Number 3, Louboutin. Louboutin in race number 96 was racing in a forward position as they entered the home straight, but when asked for an effort, didn't have much to offer, weakened and finished well back in the field. We also had number 8, which is Cormorant. Cormorant has come down from Western India and since then has had a couple of starts. In his last start, Cormorant was reported to have trotted lame after the race, even though Cormorant finished on 4th behind Excelsior. Next, we are looking at three runners here. Firstly, we have number 4, Naughty Oak. Naughty Oak, after coming down from Southern India, was racing in 3rd spot in race number 16, but finished on 4th behind Cliffhanger. In the same race, we had number 6, Rakshaki. Rakshaki has had quite a few starts in this season. Its best start came in race number 63, where it finished on 3rd behind Silver Bracelet. We also have number 7, which is Fantasia. Fantasia has had few starts in this season and his last start was racing in 5th spot, finished on 5th. The winner here was Cliffhanger, who won that race by about 3 lengths. We have two runners we're looking at. Firstly, we have number 5, Sheer Force, son of Netwiz. Sheer Force was racing in 2nd spot as the horses took the turn and at one point looked good, took charge. But there was a lead surge by Apna Tai Maiga, who drew away from them and won that race by 2.75 lengths. We also have number 10, Whispering Grass, has 4 starts. First three started, finished on 2nd each time. In his last start, Whispering Grass finished on 4th, almost 4 lengths from the winner. Next up, we're looking at number 9, Goldborn. Goldborn is by Dean Skitten. In this season, Goldborn has had 6 starts, has not been its best season so far. In last start, it was racing in 11th spot and then finished on 8th behind Big Star, almost 7.5-8 lengths behind the winner. Lastly, we're looking at number 8, Communique. Communique has had 5 starts in this season and its best start was in race number 89, where it finished on 3rd behind Treasure Hunt. In its last start in race number 105, Communique was racing in 7th spot, made some late gains and finished on 6th, almost 4.5-5 lengths behind the winner, Eastern Crown. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. See you at the races tomorrow.